properly filling out the MV1 Wisconsin title and license plate application, it's important to receive a Wisconsin title and license plates in your name. The MV1 is split into 8 sections. Click the link in the description box below for other videos in this series. Section F, License Plate Types. If you checked passenger vehicle or light truck plates in Section E, and your vehicle is for personal use, in Section F, check the appropriate license plate type box and move on to the next section. If you checked other license plate types in Section E, follow these 3 steps to complete Section F and the license plate fee portion of Section E. First, you'll determine the plate type you need. Second, you'll fill in the plate type and fee information in Section E. Third, you'll return to Section F to complete any additional information required for your plate type and vehicle use. We'll walk through the 3 steps using a motorhome as an example. Step 1 is to determine the plate type we need and take note of the corresponding 3-letter code for that plate type. Look at the vehicle type and use descriptions offered in Section F. Once you find the plate type that fits your needs, check the box to the left of the 3-letter code and make any additional selection instructed in the plate description section. The description to the right of the plate will either point you to the fee schedule to calculate license plate fees or will provide the flat fee if applicable. For our example vehicle, we have checked the MTM box as motorhome plate description best matches our vehicle. The description for motorhome plate refers us to column H of the fee schedule found on page 2 of the instructions. The gross weight fee schedule is located on page 2 of the instructions. It may appear daunting, however, you only need to use the column of the chart referenced in the description of the plate type you selected in Section F. The gross weight is the vehicle weight plus the weight of any load you plan to carry. You should register your vehicle for the heaviest you expect it will be during the registration period. In our example, for a motorhome or MTM plate, the directions say to use column H. Our motorhome is 20,000 pounds at full weight. Following from the chart, our plates will cost $93.50. On the bottom of page 2, below the chart, we see there are options for either quarterly or consecutive monthly registration. If you're interested in either type of registration period, read the information to determine if your vehicle is eligible and follow the instructions to calculate the appropriate fees. Back in Section E, if you haven't already, check the other license plate types box. Then to the right, fill in the plate information collected in step 1. For our example, we'll fill in MTM and 20,000 pounds. For registration period, we have decided to purchase annual registration. If you calculated quarterly or consecutive monthly registration fees on this line, you would indicate which registration period or periods you are submitting for. The last step for completing Section F is to review if any of the additional information on the right side applies to your situation. Here's a quick summary of each box use. The first box should be completed if the vehicle is being used for hire. If this box is checked, list your authority number, MC, LC, PC, or RC number. The second box is for motorcycles or mopeds. Check the box to ensure your motorcycle or moped is manufactured for highway use and displays a federal certification label. The third box is for RV trailers. List the length of your vehicle. The fourth box is again if the vehicle is being operated for hire. Select the appropriate motor carrier class based on how the vehicle is being used for hire. It will also show if a $5 annual permit fee is required. After selecting the appropriate box, then enter your authority number, MC, LC, PC, or RC number, below in the blank box. The fifth box should be completed if the vehicle is being registered with consecutive monthly registration. By checking this box, you verify your vehicle is eligible to be registered consecutive monthly. The sixth and final box is if the vehicle is a motor bus, school bus, or human service vehicle. School buses require proof of a state patrol inspection before titling and registering the vehicle for the first time in Wisconsin. That's it. Section F and any missing portions of Section E should now be complete with the plate type and fee information. If you skipped ahead from Section E to receive assistance in completing the license plate fee section, be sure to go back and finish watching the previous video to ensure you submit all the fees required. The Section E video is linked in the description box below. Check out the other videos in this series to complete each section of the MV1 Wisconsin title and license plate application.